Anuja Kirkar. I am a psychiatrist practicing in Thane. Mental Health for All is a session to discuss mental problems or problems related to mental health. Today we are going to discuss about a very different topic, or generally we would say a very common topic but presented in a different way, that is failure and repetitive failures causing fear of failures. Many times it happens while people coming for consultation or counseling, every time or majority of times I experience or I feel that the stress they are experiencing are due to the past experiences they have gone through, or the failures they have faced in their past or still facing in the present that are causing the issues. Failure, the definition of failures are different for everybody. One might stop his life due to failure, or an other may think that it is a stepping stone to success and move on. So it depends on you who takes it the way he wants. Failures can be in different ways, like students facing failures in exams, businessmen facing failures in business, employees facing failures in their jobs, or people facing failures in interviews, project managers facing failures in their projects. So it can be different reasons for failures and different ways of failures. Many times in my workshops or seminars, I always ask people, what are the reasons? What do you feel that, what do you think which has caused failure in your life? So people come out with many answers, like I am not financially strong, or I am not that much powerful, or I don't have a technology, the latest technology required for the project, or I don't have people supportive surrounding me, or the circumstances are not that much healthy around me, or my parents, my family are not supportive. But very few times I have seen that people take the responsibility of their failure 100%. Like, I am responsible for my failures, my efforts are not up to the mark, or I have failed in showing the sincerity which is required for doing a job. So this comes very less times, and the failures which are being faced, when they are repetitive, then it causes a fear about the failure. And actually the fear of failure is not that much important for a person, but the impact caused by the failure on their lives or on their family's life is very important. Like, what people will say if I fail, what people will think if I fail. I will be mocked by the society, I will be made fun of by the society, or my ego will be hurt, or my family will be mocked, I will be taken as a weak person, or I am not up to the mark for them. And these thoughts cause them to stop there itself without taking the action for a particular thing, and then they stop in their life, they don't move ahead, and that stopping causes stress in their life. And many times this stress leads to psychiatric problems, the reasons for headaches, the reasons for anxiety, the reasons for depression. But it is not known that these failures or the stopping of their life has caused these problems. So it's very important to move ahead in life rather than stopping. though you are facing failure, so it's okay to try to avoid the failures. Failures are going to be there if we are doing something for our lives. So our job is only to avoid or minimize the chances of failures. So there are some ways through which you can minimize the chances, or you can avoid, maybe avoid the failures also. First is acceptance of the failure. Always accept that you are failed, in spite of saying that why I am there, why I failed, no, I should not fail, how can I fail. Instead of saying this, we should accept it. Yes, I failed, now what? Second is, don't blame others for your failures. Don't play blame games. Accept it that it is my responsibility that I have failed, and take the 100% responsibility of your failure. And don't avoid the taking responsibility of the failure. Also, discuss the problems you are facing or the failure you are facing, instead of avoiding talking about it. The parents always repetitively wants to talk about the failures, but people many times avoid talking to the parents or the family or the relatives around. This causes problems in your life and in their lives too. So talk about it, discuss about it. Every time it happens that people think that if I discuss, I will be taken as a weak person in my life, I will start crying, it will show my sadness. But it's okay if you cry, if you show your sadness. They are your near and dear ones. They will totally understand you, they will support you. So talk about it, discuss about it. That will reduce your tensions, your pressures, and it will help you to vent out. Always understand your mistakes from the which you have faced in the failures, analyze it, and try to rectify the failures, so that you will next time be able to avoid the mistakes made in the first attempt. Also, talk about it with your seniors or the mentors of your field, so that they can tell you the proper path, the proper way it should be executed, so that you will not again face the failures. Also, practice is one of the thing that everybody should do, and it should be time bound. We should not think that practice will take a time and it just goes on for months and months, because it should be time bound, otherwise that time will go and it will not come back again. So timetable is also necessary for that. Time management is also one of the very biggest thing to manage, so that it will help you for your success. So these are the things which will take you towards success and help you to avoid the failures. If you want or need any information on this topic, you can contact us on our contact number 950-330-9619.